Today we're going to be building a pretty peculiar engine just due to the freaking size of it, because it's going to be a V16 that will hopefully make around 15,000 horsepower. So let's dive in to this engine. It's going to be something wild, so let's go. So we're going to be making this thing 20.4 liters large. It's going to have a 5-valve train per cylinder, that is. It's going to have a fully heavy bottom end, so it's going to include a bullet steel crank, forged heavy gun rods, forged heavy pistons, the usual stuff with VVT of course, and all our quality sliders are on plus 15. So another thing that we're going to be doing differently, we're going to be running this thing with compound turbos, because I've recently been playing with them and it's been making my life a little easier. As for the rest of the engine, that's going to be simple. It's going to be a nitromethane engine. It's going to be wild. I can't wait to see this thing make a crap load of power. But before we get into this, there's a couple of things I want to talk about, and it is involving, look at that beautiful engine, it involves the channel. I would like to get you guys' feedback on what other games should I play outside of BeamNG and also Automation. I know I've not made a BeamNG video in a while, but if you have any recommendations, do let me know down below. And also, while you're down there, do consider to leave me a comment. What's your favorite engine type, and also what do you like to see built on the channel? Car and chassis. Well, car and engine, but you know, you get the idea. But anyways, thank you for this, thank you for listening, and yeah, let's get into the madness. So as you can see here, this thing is making well over 7,500 horsepower. I am freaking excited to see where this engine goes, just due to it already being stressed, 7% and 6% on our pistons and rods. So yeah, let's see what else is bothering this engine. Okay, that's gonna be an issue. 8,400 horsepower, here we go. And the other reason why I'm actually building this engine, now that I think of it, it's to actually break the record on my channel for the highest horsepower engine. The last highest horsepower engine we did was a 13,600 horsepower, I believe it also was a V16, but that was with all the old parameters and stuff before the updates. So that's gonna be a factor to look into. So we are going to be stretching this engine, so this thing is probably never going to make it into a chassis per se, not if we can maybe revisit this engine in the future to maybe remake it so that it's a little more reliable, and also while still making top fuel dragster amount of horsepower whilst being freaking 20 liters or more large. So that's going to be something I have to consider in the future, but for now, fuck it is the words I would like to use. So I'm pretty excited. This engine is gonna be crazy. So let's see. So we're just doing the basic setup of our turbochargers and also our engine in general. There we go, 13,000 horsepower. So if we try to add game profile, it does not want to work, so to speak. But if we lower compression, there we go, we're over the record now. So that makes me pretty happy now. Let's push on, let's see if we can get our number. It's still 50% reliable, so at 14,000 horsepower. So it gives us just a rough idea of what's happening with our engine. I am gonna try and increase the timing a little bit, as I did, but our pistons are severely stressed, so that is something I have to keep an eye on. The other stuff I have to keep an eye on is our low pressure side, high pressure side, compressor and turbine, or inlet and outlet of the turbocharger. We're just gonna have to keep things a watchful eye on it. Although we're like a little bit away from making the type of power I'm looking for. So pulling some boost out of the engine does help, that's on the high pressure side. So I'm just going to quickly see if we are going to be able to measure things. And also the power curve is so freaking flat. Wow, didn't expect that. Come on, there we go, beautiful. So that's gonna be a beautiful sight of this thing making crazy horsepower. And also we're still a little bit reliable. I still am gonna play with some parameters just to make it a little bit more reliable and also make a little more horsepower. Because if we lower our RPM a little bit and we increase our spring load tension whilst messing with the compression, we can maybe get a little bit more out of it. But I don't know. We'll see. That's fine. Okay, let's mess with that a little bit. So there we go. That is freaking awesome. A 15,000 horsepower V16. That's awesome. So let's make two dyno runs and listen to this thing sing, because I've just got a feeling that this thing's gonna sound freaking awesome. And look at the size of this thing. That's gonna make a wild thumbnail. But anyways, let's get back to the dyno. Holy cow, this thing sounds wild. A freaking 20 liter V16 revving all the way out to 8000 plus RPM. That's freaking awesome. And if you would love to see more of this type of content, thank you for watching. And also, do consider to let me know if you would like to see more of this video type and also more engines, I presume. But anyways guys, have yourself a fantastic day and I'll see you again. Bye bye.